Good morning, students. Already we have completed 7.2. Now, integration using trigonometric identities. In the page number 305 of second volume. So, it is 7.3.2, integration using trigonometric identities. In some cases, we cannot integrate directly. That means, for example, integral sin square x into dx. So, we do not know how to integrate this because it is a product of two terms, that is sin x into sin x. So, we have to convert it into some addition and subtraction. Already I told you this method is also known as decomposition method. So, we know that 1 minus cos 2x equal to 2 sin square x. So, sin square x can be written as 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2x into dx. So, while integrating this is 1 by 2 and integrating 1 it is x minus cos 2x becomes sin 2x and the coefficient of x should be divided and this is plus c. So, likewise we have to exercise 7.3 question number 1 integral sin square 2x plus 5 into dx. So, let us assume let I equal to the given integral. Now, we know that sin square x equal to 1 minus cos 2x divided by 2. So, using this identity here we can write this as 1 by 2, we can take this 1 by 2 outside the symbol and sin square x becomes 1 minus cos 2 into 2x plus 5 into dx, that is equal to 1 by 2 into integral. So, bring the constant to the inside, that is 1 minus cos of 4x plus 10 into dx. So, that is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 become x and minus cos of something is sin of something, that is sin 4x plus 10 and any constant which multiplies the variable should be divided. So, accordingly it is whole divided by 4 and finally put one arbitrary constant c. So, this is the answer. So, we can multiply this. So, this can be written as x by 2 and minus sin of 4x plus 10 whole divided by 8 plus c. Let I equal to integral sin 3x cos 4x into dx. Here it is in the form of sin a cos b. Now we know that 2 sin a cos b equal to sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b, that is sin of a plus b equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. It is sin f a minus b equal to sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. So, adding these two we get, so sin a cos b. So, bring this 1 by 2 here, it is 1 by 2 into sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. Here a equal to 3x and b equal to 4x. So, accordingly we can write this as 1 by 2 into, the purpose of using this trigonometric identity is here it is in the product, it is multiplication. So, we can make it in the standard form, that is addition. So, it is easy for us to integrate when the functions are in addition or subtraction. So, we can rewrite this as sin of a plus b. A plus b means 3x plus 4x, that is 7x and plus sin of a minus b, that is 3x minus 4x equal to minus x. A plus b equal to 3x plus 4x, that is 7x plus sin of a minus b. A means 3x minus 4x equal to minus x into dx. Now, this is equal to 1 by 2 into integral sin 7x. Sin of minus x equal to minus sin x. So, we know that sin x is a odd function. So, sin of minus x equal to minus sin x. So, replace this like minus sin x whole dx. Now integrate this. That is equal to half into sin of something minus cos of something minus cos 7x whole divided by 7 and minus cos minus into minus plus cos x plus c. So this is the final answer. That is, we can multiply by the constant, we can take the constant to the that is inside, that is equal to minus 1 by 14 cos 7x plus 1 by 2 into cos x plus c. So this is the final answer. Now question number 3, we are given cos 2x, cos 2x, cos 4x, cos 6x into dx. This is product of three terms. Now consider any two of them. So let me take the first two. You can take any two, these two or cos 4x, cos 6x or even cos 2x, cos 6x. So let us consider this. We know that cos A cos B equal to half into cos of A plus B plus cos of A minus B. So in this way the first part will become integral 1 by 2 into cos of A plus B means 6x plus cos of A minus B means 2x minus 4x equal to minus 2x and into cos 6x into dx. Now multiply cos 6 with each one of them and also let us take 1 by 2 to this. So this is integral 1 by 2 into cos 6x, cos 6x equal to cos square 6x into dx plus and cos of minus theta, cos theta only. Again we have to multiply by 1 by 2. So here 1 by 2 into integral cos of minus 2x is cos 2x only because cos is an even function. So here also I am writing cos of minus x equal to cos x and this is cos 2x into cos 6x into dx. Now we have to find one formula for this cos square x. We know that cos square x equal to 1 plus cos 2x whole divided by 2. So these are all trigonometric identity we have studied in the 11th standard. So you can refer to your 11th standard book. Also I have sent one formula PDF, so you can refer to that also. So accordingly it is 1 by 4 into 1 plus x means 6x and here we have to write 2x, that is 2 times cos 12x divided by 2 into dx plus 1 by 2 into integral. Again it is in the form of cos A cos B, that is equal to 1 by 2 into cos of A plus B, that is 8x into cos of A minus B plus cos of A minus B is minus 4x which becomes cos 4x only into dx. Now we can simplify this. The first part is 1 by 4, 1 by 4 into integral 1 plus cos 12x into dx and second part is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into integral cos 8x plus cos 4x into dx. Now this 1 by 4 into x plus cos of something is sin of something, sin 12x divided by 12 plus 1 by 4 into cos 8x, that is sin 8x by 8 plus cos 4x sin 4x by 4. So taking 1 by 4 as common, we have 1 by 4 into x plus sin 12x by 12 plus sin 8x by 8 plus sin 4x by 4 plus C. Next, question number 4. Integral sine cube of 2x plus 1 into dx. Now, let I equal to the integral. This can be written as sine square of 2x plus 1 into sine of 2x plus 1 into dx. That is equal to integral. So, using the identity, sine square of something is 1 minus cos square. So, 1 minus cos square of 2x plus 1 into sine of 2x plus 1 into dx. Now, we can use substitution here. We know that the differential of cos is sine and differential of sine is cos. So, take cos of 2x plus 1 as function and find the derivative for that. So, put t equal to cos of 2x plus 1 and dt equal to minus 2 sine of 2x plus 1. So, minus 1 by 2 in dt equal to into dx sine of 2x plus 1 into dx. So, substituting these values we have, this is integral 1 minus t square into minus 1 by 2 into dt. So, for 1 minus cos square 2x equal to 1 minus t square, and for sin 2x plus 1 into dx equal to minus 1 by 2 into dt. So, this is equal to minus 1 by 2 into, so integrating 1 is t, and t square becomes t cube by 3. So, multiply by 1 by 2 on both sides, we have t cube by 6 minus t by 2. T cube equal to cos cube, that is 1 by 6 cos cube of 2x plus 1 minus 1 by 2 of cos, 1 by 2 into cos of 2x plus 1 plus c. So, this is the required answer. Next, question number 5. Question number 5. Integral, let I equal to integral sin cube x into cos cube x into dx. Now, consider this, sin cube x can be written as sin square x into sin x into cos cube x into dx. This is equal to sin square x means 1 minus cos square x, 1 minus cos square x into sin x into cos cube x into dx. So, we use the identity here and we can substitute, because the derivative of cos x equal to minus sin x, the derivative of sin x equal to cos x. So, we can take this function as cos square x cos cube x. So, we take the function as cos x and the derivative becomes sin x into dx. Now, put t equal to cos x. So, minus dt equal to sin x into dx. Yesterday we have seen this. Now, this is equal to integral 1 minus cos square means t square into cos cube means t cube sin x dx equal to minus dt. Minus dt. This is equal to minus integral, multiply this. So, t cube minus t power 5 into dt, or bring the minus inside. So, t power 5 minus t cube into dt. So, that is t power 6 divided by 6 minus t power 4 divided by 4. So, t means cos x. So, cos power 6 x by 6 minus cos power 4 x by 4 plus c. So, we can write this as, we can, okay, this is the final answer. Now, question number 6. Consider sixth question. Sixth is integral sin x, sin 2x, sin 3x into dx. So this is same type of third question. There we have integrated cos 2x, cos 4x, cos 6x. The same way we can integrate sin x, sin 2x, sin 3x. We know that sin a, sin b, sin a, sin b equal to cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. That is, cos of a minus b means cos a cos b plus sin a sin b, sin a sin b, and minus of cos of a plus b, that is minus cos a cos b, so plus sin a sin b. So cancelling this, 2 sin a sin b equal to cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. So sin a sin b equal to half into 1 by 2 into cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. So accordingly this is equal to integral 1 by 2 into cos of a minus b means cos of, so take any two of this a minus b, x minus 2x is minus x, and plus minus cos of a plus b minus cos of a plus b means 3x, so into sin 3x into dx. So multiply by, multiply sin 3x with each term, that is half into cos x minus half into cos 3x, cos 3x into sin 3x into dx. That is equal to integral 1 by 2 sin 3x cos x minus 1 by 2 sin 3x cos 3x here into dx whole dx. Now this is equal to 1 by 2 into integral again sin a cos b. Sin a cos b means 1 by 2 into sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. Sin of a plus b, so a plus b means 4x, and plus sin of a minus b means 3x minus x equal to 2x, and this is minus 1 by 2 integral. So 2 sin a cos a equal to sin 2a. Accordingly we can put 1 by 2 into this is sin 2a means sin 6x, sin 6x into dx. We know that 2 sin a cos a equal to sin 2a. So sin a cos a becomes sin 2a by 2. Now multiply this 1 by 4 integral sin 4x plus sin 2x into dx minus 1 by 4 into sin 6x into dx plus c. Now integrating this 1 by 4 into minus cos 4x by 4 minus cos 2x by 2 and minus 1 by 4 into minus cos 6x by 6. So taking my 1 by 4 as common, we have 1 by 4 into, so multiply this minus 1 by 16. So minus 1 by 16 into cos 4x, cos 4x minus 1 by 8 into cos 2x minus 1 by 8 into cos 2x and minus into minus plus 1 by 24 into cos 6x plus c. Next question number 7. Let I equal to integral sin 4x sin 8x into dx. Sin 4x sin 8x into dx. Now we know that sin a sin b equal to half into cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. We know that cos of a minus b and cos of a plus b, subtract one from another, will be getting sin a sin b. Here we can write this as half into integral cos of a minus b, means cos of a minus b 4x minus 8x minus 4x cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b, that is 12x into dx. So this is equal to half into integral cos of minus theta cos theta, therefore cos 4x only, minus sin cos 12x into dx, which is equal to half into sin 4x by 4 minus sin 12x by 12 plus c. Next question number 8. Integral 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x into dx. We know that 1 minus cos x equal to 2 sin square x by 2 and 1 plus cos x equal to 2 cos square x by 2. So these identities we have to apply here. So if we take this integral as I, we have integral. So the numerator 1 minus cos x equal to 2 sin square x by 2, in the denominator it is 2 cos square x by 2 into dx. Cancelling 2, it is integral tan square x by 2 into dx. Now we have to convert it. I told you, again we have to use one identity, tan square something equal to secant square something minus 1, that is secant square of x by 2, secant square x by 2 minus 1 into dx. Now this is equal to tan x by 2 whole divided by 1 by 2. So the coefficient of the variable x is 1 by 2, we have to divide by the same constant, and minus x. So bringing the to the numerator, that is 2 tan x by 2 minus x plus c, 2 tan x by 2 minus x plus c. And question number 9. Now question number 9, integral cos x divided by 1 plus cos x into dx. There are many methods, let I equal to consider this. So let us use one of its technique. So add plus 1 minus 1 in the numerator, that is 1 plus cos x minus 1. So the value is unaltered, adding plus 1 and minus 1 in the numerator, and we have divided by 1 plus cos x into dx. So splitting this into two terms, that is integral 1 plus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x into dx minus integral 1 by 1 plus cos x into dx. So it is integral dx minus integral 1 by 1 plus cos x, I told you 2, 1 plus cos x equal to 2 cos square x by 2 into dx. This is equal to x minus, bring the 1 by 2 to the outside, 1 by cos square something equal to secant square something, secant square x by 2 into dx. So this is equal to x minus 1 by 2 secant square integrating. So tan x by 2 divided by the coefficient should be divided. So 1 by 2, 1 by 2 cancel, that is equal to x minus tan x by 2 plus c. Next question number 10. Integral sin power 4x into dx. Now, assume this as I. Let I equal to something. Now, this can be written as sin square x the whole square into dx, because we have sin square x, the identity for sin square x, that is sin square x equal to 1 minus cos 2x by 2. So, substituting this identity, this is 1 minus cos 2x whole divided by 2 the whole square, to the whole square into dx, that is equal to, so the denominator is 4, so it is 1 by 4 we can take out and square this, a minus b whole square, that is a square plus b square means cos square 2x minus 2ab minus 2 cos 2x into dx. So, look at here, cos power 4x can be written as sin square, sin power 4x means sin square x the whole square, sin square x is 1 minus cos 2x by 2 that is whole square, and the denominator I have taken out, so 1 by 4 I have taken out, the numerator is a minus b whole square format, so a square plus b square minus 2ab. Now, this is equal to 1 by 4 integral, so this is 1 again plus cos square 2x, so cos square x means 1 plus cos 2x by 2, accordingly cos square 2x means 1 plus cos square x means 2x, so 2x means 4x, 1 plus cos 4x by again 2 and minus 2 cos 2x, 2 cos 2x into dx, that is equal to 1 by 4 integral, so this part is 1 by 2 again plus 1 by 2 1 plus 1 by 2 plus cos 4x by 2 minus 2 cos 2x into dx. Now, this is 1 by 4 integral, this is x plus x by 2 plus cos x, cos 4x means sin 4x divided by already 2, here 1 4, 4 2s are 8 minus 2 into cos 2x becomes sin 2x divided by 2. So, we have integrated and bring the 1 by 4 to the, that is x by 4 plus x by 8 plus sin 4x by 32 minus sin 2x by 4, sin 1 by 4 sin 2x plus c. So, I give you as homework, so write the cos power 4 2x equal to cos square 2x the whole square, and write the formula for cos square x, that is 1 plus cos 2x by 2. Likewise, you can solve this, and let me go to question number 12. Now, question number 12, integral sin square x divided by 1 plus cos x into dx. Let I equal to, the numerator sin x can be written as 2 sin x by 2 into cos x by 2 the whole square. So, sin x equal to 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2 the square becomes whole square. The denominator is 1 plus cos x equal to 2 cos square x by 2 into dx. Now, integral 2 square 4 and sin square x by 2 cos square x by 2 whole divided by 2 cos square x by 2 into dx. So, eliminating 2 and cos square x by 2, we have this is equal to integral sin square x by 2, sin square x by 2, 2 sin square x by 2 into dx. We know that 2 sin square x by 2 equal to 1 minus cos x. So, the identity 1 minus cos x equal to 2 sin square x by 2 into dx. So, the integral is x minus cos x becomes sin x plus c. So this is the answer. Question number 13. Here we are given like this: integral cos 2x minus cos 2 alpha divided by cos x minus cos alpha into dx. We have to integrate with respect to x. We know that cos x minus cos y, cos x minus cos y equal to minus 2 sin x plus y by 2 into sin x minus y by 2. So this is the identity we have learned in plus 1. Now accordingly this is equal to, let I equal to, so this form equal to integral cos x minus cos y equal to 2 sin x plus y by 2. X plus y by 2 means 2x plus 2 alpha by 2, eliminating 2 we have x plus y into sin of x minus y by 2. X minus y by 2 means x minus y by 2, eliminating 2 we have sin of x minus alpha whole divided by, so one put one minus, so again minus 2 into sin of x plus y by 2, that is x plus alpha, sorry, alpha by 2 into sin of x minus alpha by 2. So eliminating minus 2 into minus 2 we have this is equal to integral sin x plus y into sin x plus alpha into sin x minus alpha divided by sin of x plus alpha by 2 into sin x minus alpha by 2 into dx. So we need further simplification. Now the numerator can be written as, we know that sin x equal to 2 sin x by 2 into cos x by 2. So accordingly write each term in the numerator, that is sin of x plus alpha equal to 2 sin x plus alpha by 2 into cos of x plus alpha by 2. Again this sin format, this is 2 into sin of x minus alpha by 2 into cos of x minus alpha by 2 whole divided by, we have sin of x plus alpha by 2 into sin of x minus alpha by 2 into dx. So in order to eliminate this one, now this is cancelled and this one is cancelled, which is equal to integral 2 2s are 4, that is 2 into 2 into, again 2 into 2 into, here we have cos x plus alpha by 2 into cos of x minus alpha by 2 into dx. Now 2 integral 2 cos a cos b, 2 cos x cos y equal to cos of x plus y plus cos of x minus y. So adding these two only we are getting 2 cos x cos y. So accordingly 2 we have taken, so instead of this we can write this as cos of x plus y, here it is x, it is y, adding these two plus x 2x, alpha eliminated, so 2x by 2 equal to x plus, and cos of x minus y, cos of x minus y means x plus y by 2 minus x plus, that is x plus alpha by 2 and minus x plus alpha by 2, that is x cancel, 2 alpha by 2 means cos alpha, so the into dx, that is 2 into 2 cos a cos b equal to 2 into cos of a plus b plus cos of a minus b, accordingly this is cos x minus cos y, so 2 into, so cos x becomes sin x and cos alpha is the constant, so put 1 x into cos alpha plus c, so So this is the answer. Question number 14. Now question number 14. This is integral cos x minus sin x divided by 1 plus sin 2x into dx. We need some trigonometrical tactics. Let I equal to, this is integral cos x minus sin x is the numerator. Here 1 can be written as cos square x plus sin square x plus sin square x and plus sin 2x become 2 sin x cos x into dx. So this numerator is cos x minus sin x into dx, and the denominator is 1 is cos square x plus sin square x plus sin 2x means 2 sin x cos x. This is in the form of a square plus b square plus 2ab, that is cos x plus sin x the whole square, and the numerator is cos x minus sin x into dx. Now look at the denominator. The derivative of the denominator is the numerator. So we can put, take substitution, that is put t equal to cos x plus sin x, cos x plus sin x, and differentiating we have dt equal to minus sin x plus cos x into dx, that is cos x minus sin x into dx. Now the I equal to, therefore I equal to integral 1 by the denominator is t square and the numerator is cos x minus sin x dx equal to dt. So dt, that is integral t power minus 2 into dt, which is equal to t power minus 1 divided by minus 1, that is x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, that is equal to minus 1 by t, that is equal to minus 1 by t means cos x plus sin x, so plus c. So this is the question number 15. Integral tan cube 2x, tan cube 2x into secant 2x into dx. Now this can be written as tan square 2x into tan 2x into secant 2x into dx. So let I equal to the given function, and so split this as tan square 2x, tan 2x. Now tan square 2x can be written as secant square 2x minus 1 into tan 2x into secant 2x into dx. Now this can be multiplied into these two. So this is equal to integral secant square 2x tan 2x into secant 2x into dx minus integral tan 2x into secant 2x into dx. Now substitute for the first part, substitute for secant x, because differentiating secant x, it is secant x tan x. Now put t equal to secant 2x. Now differentiating on either side, we have dt equal to 2 secant 2x tan 2x into dx, or 1 by 2 into dt, that is bring the 2 here. So 1 by 2 into dt equal to secant 2x tan 2x into dx. This is t square. Now the integral become integral secant square 2x means t square, and the remaining part secant 2x tan 2x into dx equal to 1 by 2 into dt and minus integral secant 2x into tan 2x into dx. Now integrating this one, 1 by 2 into t cube by 3 minus, this is secant 2x by 2. So differentiating secant to x, tan to x. So integrating this one, secant to x by 2. This is equal to 1 by 6 into what is t? T means secant to x. That is 1 by 6 secant cube 2x minus 1 by 2 into secant 2x plus c. So this. Now question number 16. Question number 16 is integral tan power 4x into dx. Now we can consider I equal to tan power 4x. So that can be written as tan square x into tan square x to dx. Now tan square x become secant square x minus 1 into tan square x into dx. Now multiply by tan square x on each term, that is equal to secant square x tan square x into dx minus tan square x into integral tan square x into dx. This is equal to integral secant square x tan square x minus integral secant square x minus 1 into dx. Now for the first part put tan x equal to t, therefore differentiating tan x we get secant square x. Now put t equal to tan x, therefore dt equal to secant square x into dx. So in this first one we have integral tan x become t, so tan square x equal to t square, and the remaining part secant square x into dx equal to dt minus integral, this is secant square x minus 1 into dx. Now this is t cube by 3 and minus of secant square x becomes tan x, m become minus x. So what is t cube? T equal to tan x, therefore it is tan cube x divided by 3 minus tan x minus into minus plus x plus c. So that now question number 17 is sin cube x plus cos cube x whole divided by sin square x cos square x integral dx. Now assume that I equal to, which is equal to, split these two terms, that is sin cube x divided by sin square x cos square x into dx plus integral cos cube x divided by sin square x into cos square x into dx. This is equal to integral sin x by cos square x into dx plus integral cos x by sin square x into dx. Now for the first one, let it be I1 and I2. Let it be I1 plus I2. And for I1 equal to integral sin x by cos square x into dx. So which is put t equal to cos x. Therefore dt equal to minus sin x into dx. So minus dt equal to sin x dx. So I1 equal to, this is integral. So 1 by cos square means y 1 by t square into minus dt. So that is equal to minus t power integral t power minus 2 by minus 2 into dt. So that is equal to minus t power minus 1 by minus 1. That is plus c1 and minus into minus plus. So t power minus 1 is 1 by t power minus 1 equal to minus into minus plus, and t power minus 1 becomes 1 by t. That is equal to 1 by t means cos x, 1 by cos x plus c1. And for I2, I t equal to integral cos x divided by sin square x into dx. For this, put the denominator t equal to sin x. So, dt equal to cos x into dx. This is equal to integral, the likewise same. So, 1 by t square into dt. So, that is equal to integral t power minus 2 into dt. So, this is equal to t power minus 1 divided by minus 1 equal to minus 1 by t. So, minus 1 by t plus c, c2. So, minus 1 by t here sin x plus c2. And finally, integral sin cube x plus cos cube x divided by sin square x cos square x into dx equal to I1 plus I2. That is equal to I1 means I1 is here 1 by cos x plus c. 1 by cos x is nothing but secant x plus c1, and the second part minus 1 by sin x. 1 by sin x means cosecant x. So, minus cosecant x plus c2, which is equal to secant x minus cosecant x plus c, where c equal to c1 plus c2. Now, question number 18. Let I equal to integral cos 2x plus 2 sin square x divided by cos square x divided by cos square x into dx. Now, we know the identity, integral cos 2x plus 2 sin square x is nothing but 1 minus cos 2x whole divided by cos square x into dx. So, plus 2x cos 2x cancel. That is equal to 1 by cos square x into dx. That is equal to integral secant square x into dx. So, the answer is tan x plus c. So, integral of secant square x dx equal to tan x. So, the answer is tan x plus c.